When you switch over to a high-fiber diet, you may experience more gas formation in the stomach. As you get used to the new diet, gas formation reduces. Does it clearly mean that fiber causes gas? The answer is a bit more complex one than a simple yes or no, particularly because there are two different types of fiber which have different impacts. Let's understand the relationship of both types of fibers with gas formation and then decide what can be done to get least affected. So stay tuned to the end of this video. Fiber is a carbohydrate that the body can't digest, so passes through the body undigested. It helps regulate the body's use of sugars, helping to keep hunger and blood sugar in check. That means whether it causes gas or not, you have to have fiber in your diet to stay healthy. Now let's look closely at why does fiber cause gas? There are two main types of fiber. Each type of fiber plays a different role in digestion. Insoluble fiber adds bulk to your stool and helps food pass more quickly through the stomach and intestines. Soluble fiber attracts water and forms a gel-like substance with food to help its digestion. This process slows down digestion and helps you feel full faster, which is important in weight management. There are many other benefits of fiber, but here in this video, we will stay focused on its gas formation capabilities. Both fibers get fermented by the bacteria in the guts, but more often soluble fibers are fermented. That is why soluble fibers produce more gas. Most foods contain both types of fiber and one of them is predominant. Insoluble fiber is found in foods such as whole wheat flour, wheat bran, nuts, green beans, and potatoes. Soluble fiber is found in foods like oat bran, barley, nuts, seeds, beans, lentils, peas, and some fruits and vegetables. If you compare oat bran cereal to wheat bran cereals, then you will find that oat bran cereal causes more gas. This is because it contains high soluble fiber. As the main cause of gas formation is soluble fiber, you need to increase its consumption slowly to reduce gases. So when you decide to increase your fiber intake, be ready for more gas formation. Bottom line, fiber causes gas, so make the transition smartly by increasing the insoluble fiber food first and slowly adding soluble fiber-rich foods later. If you enjoyed the video, then give it a thumbs up and share with your friends. Subscribe to the channel to watch more videos.